Let's find out. 1, 2, 3.
Four planes change America and the world by a simple plot that exploits fatal gaps in their defenses.
Welcome to Muslim Sensitivity Training. Let's all look at why Muslims are upset. First of all, in the Muslim religion, you're not allowed to have what? Sex. Good. There's no sex until marriage in the Muslim world. Now, this would be fine, except that in the Muslim religion, you also can't... Anybody? Jack off. Okay, jacking it is strictly forbidden in the Muslim religion. And what do we know about the places Muslims live? They live in... Good sand. Now, put yourself in the shoes of a Muslim. It's Friday night, but you can't have sex, and you can't jack off. There's sand in your eyes and probably in the crack of your ass. Well, you know what? I'd be pretty pissed off, too.
Man, that woman in there poured cup after cup to every single white person around us. But did she even ask you if you wanted any?
We didn't get any coffee that you didn't want and I didn't order. And that's evidence of racial discrimination. Did you notice that our waitress was black?
And black women don't think in stereotypes? That waitress sized us up in 2 seconds. We're black and black people don't tip. So she wasn't gonna waste her time? Now, somebody like that, nothing you could do to change their mind.
So, how much is your leaving?
You expect me to pay for that kind of service? Wait. You see what that woman just did? You see that?
Why, she's cold.
She got colder as soon as she saw us, though.
Oh, man, come on, don't stop.
Man, look around you, man. You couldn't find a whiter, safer, or better lit part of this city right now. But yet this white woman sees two black guys who look like UCLA students strolling down the sidewalk, and her reaction is blind fear? I mean, look at us, dog. Are we dressed like gangbangers? Huh? No. Do we look threatening? No. Fact, if anybody should be scared around here, it's us. We're the only two black faces surrounded by a sea of over-caffeinated white people patrolled by the trigger-happy LAPD. So you tell me, why aren't we scared?
Because we got guns?
You could be right.
Get the fuck out of the car!
Okay, conversion sequence. Assist to turnover ratio divided by 2 equals polynomial of African American man. Infinity times Fisher equals shoot and a score in the basket. Okay, momentum of the derivative 2x plus infinity equals 25.7 cents. Oh, my homie Stoudemire. Yay!
Okay. If you're a black woman, and you have something to say, and you say it like you mean it, everybody portrays us. My mother, Michelle Obama, you, black girl listening, we're watching the show right now, as an angry black woman. White girls and other, Indian, Asian, the whole bit, you know, you guys are just B words. You know what I mean? That's how we're portrayed, though. And it, or doesn't she have her, does she have her period again? Right, like that. If you want to see an angry black woman, look at this.
Take you down. While the rest of these girls will look at you and be scared, I'm the girl that's not scared of you. You press the last button in me, Ms. Star Jones, and I will do you when the rest of these girls
get
won't.
Get your motherfucking ass up when I'm talking. You will be going undercover as high school students. You are here simply because you look young. You some Justin Bieber, Miley Cyrus looking motherfuckers.
Captain Sassy.
I know what you're thinking. Angry black captain. It ain't nothing but a stupid stereotype. Well, guess what, motherfuckers? I'm black, and I work my ass off to be the captain. And sometimes I get angry. So suck a dick. What I'm trying to show you is embrace your stereotypes.
See no evil, speak no evil, hear no evil. If you have not witnessed something, don't fall victim to the socially constructed views of the world. Don't you ever go on passing these misconceptions onto the rest of the world because you yourself have not established any credibility to be discussing this in the first place. Give the people that surround you the opportunity to put their individuality on display. Stop being so judgmental towards the world and accept them for who they are, not what they are. Defy stereotypes. Often have you been using stereotypes again? What about your mom? Or your best friend? It's okay, we've all been brainwashed to conform to the stereotypes of the world.